Let's talk about multiplying and dividing rational expressions. Now, all a rational expression is a fraction where the numerator and denominator are polynomials. So what we're going to do is we're going to first multiply these two fractions together, and then we're going to take what we know from this example and apply it to multiplying rational expressions. Now, if you were asked to multiply these two fractions together, what you do, of course, is you look at 15 as 5 times 3. So remember, 5 and 3 are the prime factors of 15. And then 16 is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, when you completely factor it into its primes. And then 8, of course, is 2 times 2 times 2. And then over 25, which is 5 times 5. Now, I know that when you're multiplying fractions, typically we don't write everything out like this. But the reason we're doing it here is because I wanted to make a point that whenever you simplify, or whenever you, first of all, multiply fractions, you always look to do some cross cancellation. So here I can see that a factor of 5 cancels with a factor of 5 here. And also, let's see, these three 2s, right? So 1 for 1, 1 for 1, and 1 for 1. And it's always a 1 for 1 trade when you cancel. Now that you've done all the cancellation, you multiply straight across, okay? So I'm left with, let's see, in the numerator it's going to be 3, and in the denominator it's going to be, well, 2 times 5, which is 10. So that's our answer, 3/10. Notice how I didn't multiply straight across, and, you know, I didn't multiply the numerator straight across, and I didn't multiply the denominator straight across, and then try to reduce. The reason is because you end up with really large numbers, and that's really hard. So the better way to do it is to factor and then to cross cancel. And I also want to point out that, you know, we never take this example, we never take, like, you know, 15 over 16 times 8 over 25. And you can't do this, right? You can't, let me go ahead and divide these two. You can't take 15 and go, oh, 5 plus 10 over 16, and then, you know, 8 over 5 plus 20. Now, it's true, of course, that 15 is 5 plus 10, and that 25 is 5 plus 20, but it's not really useful, right? And the reason is because you can't cross off these 5s. You can't do this. Okay, so let me just write here so that you know that we can't do this. Okay, in other words, you can't cancel when you have addition. So whenever you have addition or subtraction, forget it, you can't cancel. It's only when you have multiplication. And that's important because that reminds you that you have to factor the numerators and denominators. Okay, so let's take those observations and see if we can multiply two rational expressions together. Okay, we're asked to multiply and simplify. And of course, remember from what we just talked about a moment ago, forget about canceling the x squareds right now because it's subtraction. So what you have to do is you have to factor the numerators and the denominators. Well, that numerator, that's a difference of squares, right? So it's going to be x plus 2 times x minus 2. Okay, now these polynomials are prime. You can't factor them any further. Before we had prime numbers, now we have prime polynomials. Okay, and in the denominator, it's going to be, let's see, 3 times x plus 2. Okay, I have primes there, a prime number and a prime polynomial. For the next one, that is for the 12x, I'm going to get 2 times 2 times 3 times x. And in the denominator, it's going to be, well, let's see, this whole trinomial is going to be factored as x minus 2 times x minus 3. Now that we have everything factored, now it's time to cancel. So let's see, you can cancel an x plus 2 with an x plus 2. So you can always cancel vertically, but you can also cancel, of course, diagonally. The x minus 2 and the x minus 2. And is that it? Can this 3 cancel with that 3? No, because this 3 is all tied up in subtraction with the x, right? But what I can do is cancel this 3, which is a factor, with that 3 over there. Okay, and now that I've done all my canceling, now I multiply straight across, and I get 4x in the numerator, and in the denominator I'm left with just x minus 3. Okay, so that is how we multiply rational expressions. We first factor and then we cancel. Okay, now what about division? Division is closely related to multiplication. Let's look at one like that now. Okay, so we're going to start off thinking about dividing two fractions. So first of all, 3 over 8 divided by 12 over 5. And what we do, of course, is we leave the first fraction alone. So, you know, this is 3 over 2 times 2 times 2. And then the second fraction, well, we take the reciprocal of it after we change the operation to multiplication. So it's going to be times 5 over 12. But 12, of course, is 2 times 2 times 3. And now we do cancellation if we can. So in this case, the only factors that I can cancel are the threes diagonally. And of course, you never cancel factors that are on the same level. Okay, so now we multiply straight across, and we have a 5 divided by, let's see. Well, I'm going to have 2 times 2, which is 4 times 2 is 8, and then times the 4 here. So I end up with 5 over 32. Now, one nice thing about the way we're multiplying fractions and rational expressions is that if you've done all your cancellation, you're guaranteed that you don't have to reduce whatever you end up with because all the canceling, in essence, has been done before you actually multiply across. So at this stage, there should not be any more cancellation to be done, right? You shouldn't have to reduce this any further. Okay, now let's take those observations and apply them to when we're dividing rational expressions, which we treat like fractions. Okay, so 25x squared minus 16y squared, that's going to be 5x plus 4y multiplied by 5x minus 4y. And the reason I know that is because that numerator was a difference of squares. Okay, and in the denominator, it's just going to be 2 times x, right? Now we change this to multiplication, and we take the reciprocal of the second fraction. Now that x squared is going to be in the numerator, and I'm going to write it as x times x. And in the denominator, I'm going to have this 10x minus 8y, but I want to factor it. And what do these have in common? Well, it's going to be a 2. So I'm left with 2 times 5x minus 4y. And now we're in a stage where we can cancel. So what gets canceled here? Well, the 5x minus 4y cancels with this 5x minus 4y. And is that it? How about these 2s? No, we can't cancel those because they're on the same level. But I can cancel the x here with an x up there. And what am I left with? Well, I still have this x, right? That's not going to cancel. And I still have this 5x plus 4y. Now, usually, I know that when we have fractions, we usually multiply what's remaining like I did up here. With rational expressions, it's okay to leave your answer in factored form. That is, I'm going to leave that numerator as x times 5x plus 4y. It's okay to not multiply them out. You can leave it like that. And divided by, let's see, well, when you have just numbers, we do multiply them. So 2 times 2 is 4. So the reason we leave these as factored when you have a polynomial times another polynomial is because we're going to find this form especially useful later on in subjects like calculus when we have to set numerators equal to 0, for example. So just remember that when you have numbers, you want to multiply them together. But polynomials, it's okay at the end to leave them in factored form. And that's how we multiply and divide rational expressions. So for this last one right here, what I'm boxing would be my final answer. Okay, until next time.